My name is Jorrit Kuipers. I'm the CTO and founder of Green Dino. I'm also a researcher at the University of Twente and PhD candidate at Delft University. Here you see an example of our driving simulators. In the middle, it's a bus and truck simulator, and at the right, one of our car simulators. Our car simulator is used for the first lessons in the training of young drivers. And you can see on top of the monitor, there is a webcam that looks at the orientation of the head. And using this camera, we can assess the field of view of the student.
Increase your distance. You are approaching a vehicle in front. Use the 2-second rule to maintain a safe driving distance. You will shortly approach an unmarked junction. Look out for the signpost and use your mirrors in good time. Turn right here. Look to the side. Indicate right. Keep as far to the right of the lane as you can. Increase the distance to the vehicle in front. Reduce acceleration. Before reaching the desired distance, accelerate a little harder. Increase the distance to the vehicle in front. Reduce acceleration. Before reaching the desired distance, accelerate a little harder. You are not using your mirrors.
Young drivers are overrepresented in road incidents. And this is a global problem. Also in the video, we could see that the young driver takes too much risk and was only focused on the driver in front of him, what led to tunnel vision. This dangerous behavior is a result of the lack of experience and an overestimation of the own driving skills. Due to a focus on dangerous incidents during driving examination, accident-prone drivers can too easily pass the test. This is because during this examination, no dangerous incidents happen. Driving simulators for car driver training and testing offer several advantages for lowering road incidents. The effects of simulated training and testing on crashes and incident risk in the European Union are not evident yet. In this cohort study, we investigated for the Netherlands whether driving simulators with automated instruction and assessment influence incident with bodywork damage and incidents with hospitalization after licensing. Also, we looked whether automated training and testing on driving simulators can lower the incident risk of young car drivers. Here, a safety report is presented, giving insight in driving skills of the student. We can seek for correlations like the scores on turning right, keeping a safe speed, and the observation and anticipation during this execution of the driver task. And we can see here that speeding leads to tunnel vision with a lower score on observation and anticipation, and also a lower safety risk score. Here in this video is presented how we assess driving skills. We will follow a blue car that is in a curve and will overtake bicyclists. But on the other lane, a car is coming and the blue car has to stop the action, the overtaking, and go back to his own lane. And during this action, we assess the risk, and it is in the risk graph presented. So here we can see the intention to overtake, but it calculates that a collision can happen, and in the graph, the risk is presented. Also, the car looks into the left lane and sees that the side is blocked, that it cannot overtake, and then a red light is turned on, it will not overtake the bicyclist. Looking at our study, we investigate the behavior of Dutch car drivers, in total a group of 2,439 drivers that drove on driving simulators and on the road in the period between 2008 and 2015. We looked at the performance in the driving simulator, also the number of on-road lessons during the training, and the performance on the driving exams. After that, we looked at the involvement in incidents on the road. Here we see the whole group. A partition between simulator learner drivers and regular learner drivers, the control group. Then we looked at simulator learner drivers who got automated feedback on field of view training, on field of view, and simulator learner drivers who did not get this automated feedback on field of view. And we looked at differences between simulator drivers who followed the hazard perception training and learner drivers who didn't follow the hazard perception training. So that was the rest of the group. What we found is that automated simulator training lowered the number of lessons needed to obtain a driving license. It increased the passing rate on the first driver exam, and those two things are correlated, of course. More important, we saw that simulator training reduced most drivers' incident involvement and incident risk. In the first 12 months after licensing, almost all incidents involved bodywork damage. In the last 12 months of driving, after the first 12 months of driving, nearly all incidents involved hospitalization. We also found that the incident risk of females in the first 12 months after licensing was twice as high as that in males. If we look at the absolute risk of females, it's lower than of males, but if we correct for exposure, kilometers driven or miles driven, then we found that the incident risk of females was twice as high as that in males. We also found that field of view training and hazard perception training increased the passing rate and decreased the incident risk for both gender. Effects of age, gender, education, learning style, experience, exposure, errors, and violations were identified and were equal to other research. We should keep in mind that group differences and self-selection effects revealed the complexity of car driver training and testing. Automated training, testing, and monitoring of information processing skills have great potential for lowering incident involvement and should be the subject of new research and development. Still, exposure was the determining factor in reducing incident risk for all groups. We formulated a rule of thumb. The incident risk drops approximately 10% per 1,000 kilometers driven, meaning that it's not our goal to lower the amount of kilometers by higher passing rates. The results of this study showed that drivers who followed 8 or more lessons on a simulator and received automatic field of view training had a 36.8% lower severe incident risk than drivers who only followed regular on-road lessons in the last 12 months of driving. Drivers who followed hazard perception training in combination with field of view training on a simulator reported 72.5% lower incident risk than drivers without hazard perception training with equal exposure in traffic in the first year of driving. Because the hazard perception training was introduced in 2013, we had no data on incidents in the last 12 months of driving. Field of view and hazard perception training are considered low-order skill training and were more successful than higher order skill training commonly preached and practiced in Europe. The results of this research contribute to the evidence that simulator training has indeed improved road safety in the Netherlands. However, self-selection, self-reporting, and non-randomized testing should be considered. We believe that on-road monitoring and automated feedback can further improve road safety also after licensing. Here you can see an example of on-road monitoring. We follow the car on the road and combine it with the safety state assessment that was already shown that we use in simulation. This is the end of my presentation. I hope you liked it. And for more questions, you can reach me by email. Have a nice day. Bye bye.